It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, first of all, before we have a chat about the latest releases, we need to mention that Liquid Forks, the new and improved Liquid Forks, are in stock.
Could you tell?
Yeah, we've been playing around with these already this morning. And you're actually a lot happier about this, aren't you, Sean?
I'm a lot happier. I've not been able to do this in the past because I work with some pretty rough people. I don't mean rough as in bad. I mean like pretty strong and football events and stuff. And they like to examine the forks and try and bend them back. And I had a bit of a problem. I'd have had a bad experience with the old Liquid Forks. And now the new improved...
And what was the bad experience? They took it off
They took it off me and bent it back.
Yeah.
Okay. And so, but now with these, it means that you can't bend them back, which means they can be examined, which means it's a more impossible object, which now makes this performable for me, and I can't wait to go out and do it.
What we've done, we've had quite a few prototypes in, and we've been experimenting with the right pliability versus strength.
Mm-hmm.
So it's still easy to bend them in performance and put the twists in, like the handle bend and that kind of thing, as long as your technique is absolutely spot on, you're not going to have any problems with this at all. But when you do hand them over to spectators, because the way they've been pre-treated, they will not be able to bend them back at all.
They're really solid afterwards as well.
Whereas the other ones, because of the way they've been pre-treated, when they bend, you can't bend them back afterwards. Mm. They kind of freeze and stick in this position. And you'd have to put a lot more energy in to bend them back.
Now, here's the thing. I'm not saying that you won't be able to. I don't think we can say, oh, you won't be able to. If somebody tried really hard and you got that guy, he would be able to bend them back if he tried really hard. But the point is, you'd have that spectacle of him there really. You've just bent it like with magic. And he's having to like really
exert himself
just to do it. So he's making you look good just by bending them back.
You know, the twist on the handle, even with a big guy, it was pretty impossible to take it out.
You're not going to take that out.
But you're never going to get this out. The only way to put that in is if you're absolutely spot on with your technique whilst you're performing it and using the correct mind power. So they're back in stock at World Magic Shop, the new and improved Liquid Forks. And along with the Liquid Forks, you get the original Liquid Forks routine, which is available as a free download. And we'll be putting some extra information on there, some extra tips as well, and some extra twisting tips to go with the new and improved Liquid Forks. But to go along with that, we're not actually going to review this product because everybody is aware of our association with Morgan, because obviously these are Morgan Strebler's official Liquid Forks. But we are going to have a quick chat about Liquid Killer. We've all watched it. We've all watched the routine. It's about a 50-minute DVD, very well produced from Sans Mines.
Yeah.
Guys, what did you think?
Brilliant.
Brilliant.
Why did you think it was brilliant? I'm interested in this because I'm slightly biased.
If you don't do the original Liquid Forks routine, this is taking it a little bit further. It's got some lovely ideas in there as well. Morgan comes across brilliantly and he just presents it very, very well.
It's completely different, isn't it?
Well, it is.
It's completely different. And what I like, I'm talking about card magic as an example, is I like, if I'm putting a routine together, I don't just want to go, I bought that DVD, I'm doing that routine. I like to go and find all my favourite visual moments and put them all together in one. And now, this is another bit of stuff. This is some incredible eye candy on there.
Yes.
And I can now take bits from here, bits from there, bits from there, a couple of bits from this, and make my own unique routine that I'm going to enjoy going out and performing that nobody else is going to be doing.
Yeah.
Because I put my own series of things together.
And I think that's what I do with the routines that I've kind of put together over the years. You've got a bit from Jerry and Banachek, a bit from Morgan, a lot from Morgan in fact, a bit from D. Christopher's Metal DVD, and putting all this together. And you know, if you're going to go into any metal bending at all, World Magic Shop would recommend that you get all these DVDs, including the original Liquid Metal, Psychokinetic Silverware, Jerry and Banachek, and Metal by D. Christopher. I do believe that if you add Liquid Killer to that collection, you have got the definitive educational piece of work on metal bending. And whether you use all of Liquid Killer or just a little part of it, like Sean said, you owe it to yourself, really, to just check out and study and learn what Morgan has brought to the table next. And what he has brought to the table is another very unique final display. Because that was the thing that was unbelievable many years ago. When you first saw this fan of Tynes.
Oh, I remember.
The first time you see this, and it happened to me at Blackpool, and all of a sudden they stop and they're like this, you can't believe what you're saying.
Yeah.
Now, if you've been performing liquid metal from some time, and you've got all that experience, you've been using the liquid forks routine mainly, you're not going to have a problem adding elements or the liquid killer finale.
And also, the opening to the routine actually throws everybody off the scent of the actual method for the rest of it. Because if you know how it's done, obviously it bends in a certain way, and that certain way that you get the main bend in the fork is similar in lots of different routines.
Yeah.
What this is doing, straight from the outset, if any spectators were to suspect that, it's putting a bend in the fork, which would be impossible to do using that method.
Yeah,
Away you've got that nice little visual bit. So then when you do the normal bend a bit later on, they're not, their brains are so far removed from going down that sort of method anyway.
It's got some great moments. He's got a single fork routine, a double fork routine. It's got elements of the destruction routine that he featured on his FISM competition entry act many years ago, which I was lucky enough to see live. Look, it's all there. It's his last piece of work from the last 10 years on the subject, and it's available on DVD.
If you want to do fork bending, that's where you start, you know. I think that's where you finish, really. Well, everything's on there.
There's a lot of people that get into it. Some people leave it behind, but a lot of people, like myself and many other pros out there, stick with it because it is such an incredible giveaway. And this, combined with liquid forks that are better than ever before, means that you are leaving somebody with a souvenir of your performance that they will never, ever forget. And right now, with the new liquid forks, it's impossible to comprehend how that has happened. Next, we've got Tunnel by Knee from Sans Minds, the guy that sent over a Dropbox link to the team at Sans Minds Creative Lab, and they said, we'll bring that out, along with this gimmick that's inside there with the DVD.
Yes. And not only that, a complete brand new comedy routine.
Tell us about this routine.
Was it funny?
It was hilarious. I'm a comedy magician. I love it when new comedy routines come out. And this routine that comes with it, I don't know if you get TV rights with the routine or not.
Read the box.
I don't know if you get the script, but there is a script that comes with it. It doesn't say that you can't use the script. It just says TV rights not included with purchase, all rights reserved. So I presume that in performance you can use the script, and it has got a killer line.
Go on, watch it.
I'm going to do it now. Please hold out your hand. No, the clean one.
Oh, that is dynamite. Tell me I get the rights to use that line.
Doesn't
that
say
is
you
brilliant.
Don't get the rights.
He does say that in the video.
That is brilliant. In fact, it's reiterated in the instructions as well as part of the motivation for doing some secret tricky little move with the gimmick. Yeah. What do you think to the trick? Let's summarise. What's the trick?
Let it get two separate different bills.
Signed.
You can sign both of them.
Bills.
And you put them
in. What you did there.
Thank you. Very international. You put it inside an envelope that you get in the casing.
An ordinary black envelope.
Yeah, which opens both sides.
Which is double-sided, like a tube.
Yeah, and you can look right through it. There's nothing else in there. You can look through it, though.
Yeah, they can't check it.
It's an ordinary envelope. Why can't they examine it?
I don't know. Carry on.
You put it, you put the bill each side, the one that they've signed, and then you can slap your hand down, snatch it out their hand while they're holding it out of it, and they're left with each other's bill.
Do you know what? It is funny because we know, right? I wouldn't do this at a gig, you wouldn't do it at a gig. But I can see this being set at where it'd be really cool to figure out that either that macho guy in the bar that's got his trick that he wants to show everybody, or a kid, and they set up and it does look like something cool's about to happen.
I'm gonna say this now.
You got this big thing.
Do you know that thing that you do where you get them to hold it and drop it and you catch it and you start off with this and then you say, right, let's sign it or take it to the next level, and then you just snatch it and walk away.
Yeah, it's that.
You might have a little routine there, but
It's a bar trick. It's a bar trick.
I think if you presented it like a bar trick with a little bit of magic at the end of it,
I think it'll work well.
You might absolutely.
You're holding these. Can we
make this
look
mind again.
Well, look, I like to keep you on your toes.
Oh, no, you have a fiver. You have a ten. If we can swap it round without you leaving go of it, then we keep the money that we've got through. You show you're holding yours. 1 to 3, boom, you make a fiver every time you do the trick.
And you throw in more comedy lines like, is that yours, is that yours, must be mine. You walk off with the money after saying you've got the clean one.
Who gave me that
And then you
one?
Go, you've killed them with comedy.
Write your name on that.
I think this is a nice little thing.
The gimmick
I'm not going to perform
works. It needs to be different coloured notes if you can.
Oh, yeah. You need to do a lovely contrast. So it's bang, you can see that.
It's not something that I'm going to do, but I don't dislike it. So I'm giving it 71%.
Yeah, I quite like it. I'm not going to do it. I
this could be a video.
This
could be a video for you. Live video. Do it. Do it. You need to do it at one of your gigs. Live video.
What are you going
to
give it? What are you going to give it,
Listen,
Sean?
The contract that we have written up, unlike, you know, we say sometimes I have to give Wayne stuff to do this contract. But
contract.
There's no contract saying that I have to do things.
What are you going to do? What are you going to give it?
Should I do it again?
What are you going
to
give it?
I think you need to do it. I think you
should
need to try
it. Should I set it up like some big thing?
Yeah,
about,
I think you need to
standing
do it.
On a chair.
We need to have the
I've
footage.
Done it. I've done a product that I reviewed at a gig.
Yeah, and I did in 1998, I put a video up, so yeah, I think you should
Sean's
do it.
Sean's going to do it. Sean,
how much are you going to give it?
Well, if I'm going to perform it,
you've
got to
give
it 90%.
Yeah. He's going to perform it, he's giving it 90%. How much are you going to give it, Wayne?
73.
Next, we're on to the battle of the ring and the necklace.
Yeah.
The World Magic Shop email has been on fire with people writing in saying, what is the best, Volant or Snag? People that want to do the ring on necklace routine. So we're going to give you our no holds barred opinion on that right now. Let's talk about the differences, first of all, in the routine, because there are slight differences. What happens with Volant? What do people see happening, Wayne?
They get the you borrow a ring from someone, you can drop it in your hand, you make it vanish, you pull out your chain, which is around your neck, and their ring is no doubt linked on your necklace.
Linked onto the chain, and it comes off. Snag. What does snag look like?
Well, snag looks like you make the ring disappear.
Similar sort of way.
I like Alan's better. We've got some nice subtleties in there to make it right. So
let's not get onto the review just yet.
But you make it disappear, then you put your hands around your neck, you take your necklace off.
No, snag.
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 That's Volant.
Yeah.
Oh, did you just do Volant?
I just done Volant.
Oh, no, snag. Sorry, you go in your shirt.
Yes.
You take it out, and you'll come straight in through the buttons of your shirt, you take it out, and it is linked.
It's linked right
there.
Yeah,
it's linked there, you undo it at the back of your neck, and then you tip it off.
So we had a chat before we started to do the review and turn the camera on with some basic sort of pros and cons. First of all, Volant. What are the advantages, the pros to Volant, first of all? First of all, quick loading. We all agreed on that, didn't we?
Very quick, actually. I like the way that it loads up as well.
What we're talking about is how quickly you can get the ring from its hidden position to actually being perceived by the spectator as linked onto the chain.
I love that. But what's even better is the setup.
The reset.
To put it on, you literally just bang, it's back on. That's it. That's the reset.
Right. Now let's talk about the pros. The pros with Snag. So one thing that we all agreed on was
the
look of the chain.
That is the
main thing. It looks like a regular chain.
Yeah.
So it looks like a nice thin gold chain or silver if you want to. You get a chain in the box as well. But you've got a chain and it looks like a regular chain. And because it's a real chain and a genuinely real chain, it can be examined afterwards.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Yes.
They are the main pros of those two routines, be it Volant or Snag. You'll have to make your mind up watching the full live performances, which are quite honest and they're available there on the internet, whether you like the structure of the routine or not, whether you're taking it out from here or here. What are the cons, the problem with Volant,
what is the chain?
You can't examine the chain.
Yeah.
The chain is not a real chain with Volant. It's part of the methodology behind it, and it doesn't look like a regular chain. And it's got certain style requirements, would you say?
Yeah, it's
that?
A bit kind of sort of a bit grungy. You know, it's got a little bit of a rocker look to it. It's a bit bulkier. It doesn't look like an elegant chain necklace.
Which is a pro and a con.
Yeah. Oh,
so
you're right.
Okay, I don't think Alan addressed this on the explosion. I can't wear that at a gig.
No. The kind of person who would be wearing,
but
now, there are certain people who wouldn't wear an elegant chain. So yes. It's, you're dead right.
They're the same performance styles as your tattoo guy and your all that. You know that would suit them better. Whereas I think we at a gig would prefer a chain.
But 100%. It can't be examined.
Yeah.
Because it's not a real chain. It's a very cleverly gimmick, ingeniously gimmicked chain.
Very clever.
There's been other versions out before which are fully credited on the DVD. Two other people are credited.
Yeah.
But it's a gimmick chain. The con with Snag, the main thing for me is how long it takes to reset.
I don't like the reset on this.
Yeah, so me watching the Snag, I would say, if I was doing this as part of a parlour show, then it would be worth me going through all the resets. I'm just doing the trick once that night, and then that's it.
Ben, who's a very sort of creative young magician, he says he can reset it in a few seconds. I think, personally, I would struggle to do it in a few seconds, less than 10 seconds. I'd want to make it right. And the other negative with it,
I quite like that. I don't normally have a problem with reset if I'm strolling from group to group, table to table, because that's my setup time. As long as I can look at a table and say, right, it's going to take me 5 seconds to walk over there. Can I set this in 5 seconds? Yeah. Snag, no.
No.
And I think you would be messing
and
about.
And you certainly can't be doing it in front of people.
No.
There's definitely angle restrictions, whereas with Valance, everything
thing.
Is kind of covered with the natural motion that is very similar to a Regal ring chain style presentation. Mm. But there is certainly a little bit more angle issues with Snag. Now, what I'm going to say is, having watched Snag, there are angle issues, but I do believe, with a little extra thought, and rather than attaching the gimmick to your shirt, you actually put it on something inside, a little bit further inside here, maybe directly onto your chest, or like you said, Sean, on a t-shirt.
Yeah.
I think you could make this not angly at all.
Yeah, and definitely.
Just a general discussion now about the two guys, because it is difficult. There's so many pros and cons with each thing.
There's a real mixture of them as well, isn't there? There really are some powerful points
for
each one.
First of all, in order for you to make that decision, you have to decide where you're performing the trick.
Yeah, okay.
And we've identified that you don't necessarily want to be doing Snag table.
Yeah.
But if you were dead certain that you had to perform a ring on neck, then so you'd have to go for Valance, or but then from a daytime point of view, if I'm having the time to treat coffee shop magic that I might perform 3 or 4 times throughout the day, am I going to set Snag up just in case
we must go on record again and say that the creators believe they can set it up quickly.
Yeah.
It's just us that believe we couldn't set it up
that
quickly.
It's more that.
I would want to do an extra setup to make it even cleaner and improve the
action. Yeah. And even that setup, the fiddly bit, if I'm going out, sorry guys, I've got to go to the toilet again now so I can set up my magic trick.
I really don't like that.
So I suppose with a daytime thing, if you're that relaxed type character, then Volant would be beneficial. But in a parlour show setting, if I wanted to do a ring routine, then I'm gonna go with Snag.
Yeah, I'm gonna say that I'm happy with my ring on key ring because I've used it for many years, which is an El Duco design, and it works very very well in a designer key case, and that fits. That works with my style with a ring on string routine. What I would say is, if I was gonna film one for a special, or I was asked to do it once for a jewellery store or something like that, I would be going with Snag. Mainly because I just think it looks a little bit more elegant. I do like, when I watched it and I watched the explanation, I was a little bit blown away by how clever it was. Yeah. Mm. Whereas I think most people with Allen's, and it doesn't take anything away from it, know how it works. Mm. I think most magicians, before they buy it, even though the gimmick is great quality, I think they know what it is.
I
didn't know how Snag worked. when I found out how it worked, I wasn't disappointed. I thought that I'd learned something very good that actually fooled me, because I couldn't work out how a ring could just be on a chain and you've gone inside your, you know, your shirt here and it's on there, you unclip it and it comes out. I couldn't work that out. And I was very impressed with the method. I think the way that it's all seated inside your shirt could be improved slightly, but you wouldn't have to put too much thought into it. So I prefer Snag slightly. It's got the slight edge
I don't,
for me.
I don't borrow people's jewellery. I don't borrow finger rings, so I won't be performing any of them. However, I do like... I'm so drawn to the way that Snag... is a company, you know, all the dirty stuff. I love the way that works.
Yeah, it's
clever. I really do. But however, I do like the cleanness of the reset of the lamp. The way you just put the chain back on. That's it.
If you had to pick one, Wayne, which one are you gonna pick? If you had to pick one, somebody said you're going out and you're working one from now on. Which would
Snag?
You?
I would do Snag because it looks like a real chain. And it's simply because it looks like a real chain.
Now let me flip this slightly, because I'm trying to be really fair here. If you had a style that the chain from Vallant suited you, would you pick Vallant?
Yeah, definitely. If I
it's
was
so difficult, right, isn't
okay.
It?
Let's say then. Let's
We're
say,
a completely different style.
It looks like that Vallant. I'm going to say it suits a chap who's kind of sort of
urban.
Urban, yeah. It's that grungy. It's the guy who's been free running and jumping around and scouting about on a BMX.
Like Alan Robertson.
Yes.
A bloke with Send us a video of you free running, Alan. We'd love to see that.
Yeah.
So, what are we saying? Are we all preferring Snag overall, but mainly due to our style?
It's only simply because the way the chain looks for me.
What we're going to say is both are very good.
Yeah.
They've all got their merits, they've all got their pros, they've all got their cons. Hopefully this discussion has helped you enough to make a decision. I don't think I've made a final decision yet, because there's so many pros, so many cons in different directions.
Tricky one.
Hopefully that's helped you in some ways. I'm not sure it has helped you. I'm not sure if it's confused you even
more. They're
both
very good.
But they are both very good, and they all have their merits, they all have their pros. They all have their cons. Thank you for joining us this time on the Wizard Product Review. Until we see you next time at 12 o'clock on a Wednesday sometime. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review.
1. Take this one and put it right over here.
Okay.
All right, now, each one of you only hold one hand out. Whatever hand is clean. Is that a clean hand?
Sure.
Actually, do my stand right over here real quick. All right.